Welcome to the Chum City building. We have a very, very special night tonight because we like to call it an intimate and interactive, which will feature the one and only, the legendary vocals of Meat Loaf. How y'all doing? I'm Master T. Come on this way. It's intimate because there's a whole bunch of cats inside and they're ready to almost touch Meat Loaf, ready for him to just drop a note. It's interactive because you people out there, you can get to respond to us via fax, via phone, or email, all the rest of that. Well, you know, Meat Loaf has a brand new sheet. You just happen to have it in my pocket. Here it is. Welcome to the Neighbourhood. And you know what else? He's gonna be performing tracks from his classic album, Bat Out of Hell. And you know what? Meat Loaf is just kinda chilling out there. But you know what? It's about that time for some LIV vocals. From the one and only Meat Loaf. Are you ready? Meat Loaf in our intimate and interactive. Let's go.
On a hot summer night, would you offer your throat to the wolf with the red roses?
Will he offer me his mouth?
Yes.
Will he offer me his teeth?
Yes.
Will he offer me his jaws?
Yes.
Will he offer me his hunger?
Yes.
Again, will he offer me his hunger?
Yes.
And will he starve without me?
Yes.
Then does he love me?
Yes.
Yes.
On a hot summer night, would you offer your throat to the wolf with the red roses?
Yes.
I bet you say that to all the boys.
Beginning to grieve, oh, and I live on with a new loving while you were kissing me. You took the words right out of my mouth. Oh, I swear it's true. I just about to say I love you. Hang on, 1 second. Oh, God. I've made a huge mistake here tonight, guys. I thought I was in Toronto. I'm sorry. I really apologize to you guys. This is Winnipeg. Because, I mean, the people of Toronto can damn well sing, and you people suck, man. Now, I wasn't wrong, now was I? No. I said I wasn't wrong, now was I? No. This is Toronto, Canada. No. And we, right here tonight, we must set an example for the whole country, right? We're gonna start to sing again. And this time, I want these people here in front not sitting down. You stand up. Get up off your ass. Come on. Stand up back there. All of you people are representing Canada here tonight. Now I want to hear some singing. Are you ready? Are you truly, truly, truly ready? Canada! Don't you just love how we're going into a ballad on the second song? Most bands will play some damn rock and roll song now, not me. In fact, I'm even bringing over a stool. This is intimate, right? Now, intimate. I was naming some cookie in the States here. We'll be right back. is crazy. Some boy's half out of his head. Somewhere there's just the moment where all remains unsaid. Somewhere two hearts are pounding and they don't care what's correct.
What an intimate and interactive is all about.
Tony, how are you?
What's up, Meat? How are you?
Thank you very much, everyone. That was, Hey, Tony, come here. Come here.
All right.
You sit here and hang on to that.
Sit there? All right. All right, babe, grab a seat. It's been a while.
Oh, man, I'm telling you.
You know what? You are one of the hardest working people in show business. Give it up for this man. Wait. That's one thing I've always admired about you is when you come to kick it live, you come to kick it live.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you.
All right, you know what? You've also got a great band with you. So,
oh, man, absolutely. This is one of the best bands in the world, bar none. Let me just say thank you before we introduce the band. Just say thank you to everyone here. Thank you to everyone out there. And that was the, if I can talk, Tony, that was the title track to the new album, Welcome to the Neighbourhood. Right. And written by, ready for this? It was written by two writers who write for Sesame Street. This song was originally intended for Big Bird, but I got it from him. Big Bird may be big, but I'm sorry, you know? Where is he? Ladies and gentlemen, on guitar. One of the absolutely best in the entire world, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pat Thrall. Oh, I didn't introduce him as the snake, but that's okay. On piano, Mr. Mark Alexander. When he's not playing drums, he runs a jackhammer for the city of New York. Ladies and gentlemen, on drums, Mr. John Michelli. A man who has been here for a very long time, if not in body and soul, but in spirit, was on the very first album, Bat Out of Hell, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chasm Sultan. Right here, I have the leader, musical director of this motley crew. He has been standing to my right side for almost 19 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Steve Buslow. Oh, on bass guitar. This is a true story. She was working in a hair salon, cutting hair, and working in an Italian wedding band. Came and auditioned for me. Didn't think she got the whatever this thing is she's doing here, whatever this thing is, and we saw her kick a bus as she was leaving. I hired her because she kicked the bus. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Patricia Russo.
All right, and now.
And ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, the irrepressible, the man about town, the true sex god of Toronto, Muchmusic, Tony.
Thank you. Right back at you. One of the consummate performers, a true legend in rock and roll. Like I said before, when
true linkage.
When he kicks it live, oh, yeah. Let's give it up for him. Meat Loaf, come on. All right. Now we want to get to the interactive part. How do you interact with us? Here's the digits. Roll them.
If you'd like to get intimate and interactive with Meat Loaf for questions and comments, the toll-free number to call is 1-800-265-MUCH. That's 1-800-265-6824. By fax, the number to call is area code 416-591-MUCH. That's area code 416-591-6824. By email, send your questions and comments to muchmail@muchmusic.com.
All right, we are back, and now, okay, let me just get it right. It's Meat or Meatloaf? How do I address you tonight, babe?
Tony, it's Meat. Ever since I was 4 years old, my dad gave me that name, the same as probably your dad gave you your name. And you were named after a permanent, right, Tony? Comes in a box?
It certainly does.
That's right, and so I was named after a large slab of cow, that's all.
All right, Meat.
You know, there's people out there named Dick. I can't tell you what they're named after.
You know what? And I'm not going to touch that one. Enid?
Hi.
Hey, you have a question for me?
Yes, hi, me. I'm wondering, the time span between Bat Out of Hell and Back Into Hell was quite a few years. Were you surprised with the reaction you got? It was so positive.
I'm surprised if I get up every morning and put my feet on the floor and manage to get to the bathroom. I'm telling you that right now. I'm surprised by everything, and I'm... not only surprised, but extremely grateful, and everything that comes to me is a blessing, and I just say thank you, and I thank God for it. So there you go.
All right, thanks, Edith. All right, it's about that time for another live performance, and this.
Already, I'm just recovering from the last two.
We're working you tonight, baby.
Yeah, you are.
You are ours.
Okay.
All right. This track was actually written by Van Halen's Sammy Hagar, and the track is Amnesty Is Granted off the brand new album, Welcome to the Neighbourhood. Meat Loaf in the house, come on!
We'll be right back.
Thank you, Meat Loaf. We will be back with a whole bunch more. We've got phone calls, we got faxes, we have email on this intimate and interactive. Plus, we will get to hear the big, massive hit I'd Lie For You all on the intimate and interactive with Meat Loaf. Come on back. To our I&I, Intimate Interactive with Meat Loaf. And, you know, you can respond to us in various ways. We've got the phones, we have the faxes, and as well, we have our email wrangler herself, the beautiful and talented Corinne. How you doing, Corinne?
Fine, thank you, Tony.
All right, so what's happening on the email for Meat Loaf?
Well, we have a message from Sheldon Davies, who has a question for Meat Loaf. He writes, who are your influences in music?
Whistling back at me.
Okay, I think we...
Are we on the air?
Yeah, we are. I think we missed a question there. Hold on a sec.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's no problem. Can we get the email question again?
Meat Loaf, who are your influences in music?
Who are your influences in music?
The head football coach of the Toronto Argonauts.
Yeah.
Also, most of the defensive line influences me every day, as you can tell. In fact, you know, I was made an honorary member of the Toronto Argonauts, and ever since then, they have been my influence in music completely.
Well, you know they're not winning, right?
What?
You know we don't know.
Tammy in Vancouver. Well, who was winning? Who's winning?
Who's winning?
Yeah.
Play today?
No, who?
The Leafs.
The Leafs? The Leafs are my major influence in music.
All right.
Well, when the Argonauts were winning, they were, but now they're losing.
And then the Raptors.
Forget them.
All right, you know what? We have a phone call.
I go with the winner every time, folks. Okay, a phone call.
Tammy, are you on the line?
Yes, I am.
How you doing?
Fine, how are you?
Called all the way from Vancouver. What's your question for me?
I'd like to ask him, what would he like to be remembered for?
What?
One more time, please.
What would he like to be remembered for?
What would you like to be remembered for?
Oh, for the same as the Boy Scouts. Trustworthy, loyal, and truthful. And also for never striking out in a softball game. Also for batting 500 at the New York Yankees fantasy camp last year. And let me think, what else? Don't be putting up a sign. I'm still figuring out what I want to be remembered for, okay? This could go on. This, how long is this show? 3 or 4 hours, right?
Three or four hours. Good.
How's that, Tammy?
Oh, that's perfect. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome, Tammy. Tammy, what would you like to be remembered for?
My personality.
Oh. I agree with that, Tammy.
Okay, thank you so much.
I think you have a great... you know what? I want to be remembered for my personality, too.
Well, it's wonderful.
Boy.
All right. Joan, over here, we have a question at the...
Okay.
All right, introduce yourself.
Yes. I would like to know how it is being on tour away from your family. And I understand you have two kids, a daughter and a son.
No, I have two daughters. But the two was right. And really, truthfully, my wife is sitting right there, by the way. My family really does come first, okay? And... I've been married to my wife for 20 years, and she has guided me through some of the worst times that you could possibly imagine, things that you wouldn't want your worst enemy to go through. And because of the love that she gave me, I'm still standing here. And the love she gave our kids, they're great. Their names are Pearl, who is 20, and Amanda, who is 14. And that's my family.
All right, we have a fax, and it's from Wanella, and she's from Brampton, Ontario, and she says, do you find you still have your old fans, or are you gaining a lot of new ones?
I don't know. Let's find out. I right there, I can tell right there that he's a new fan. He's a new fan. There's a really old guy up there somewhere that's an old fan. And I think it's a mixture, and I'm thankful for every one of them. In fact, after this show, I planned on kissing them all singly.
Yeah.
No tongue action for the guys, though. Let me tell you that right now. No French kisses for the guys, but the girls get double.
Oh, there you go. All right.
That's why I've been married for 20 years, because I'm just this silly.
All right, we actually have a question from our speaker's corner, and let's roll the speaker's corner and let's check out the question.
Stand I by love us. Speaker's corner. I keep wanting to go in there, but I don't have a
Listen carefully.
My name's Daniel McDougall, and I'm from Charlottetown, and I want to ask Meat Loaf, do you feel that you're making the same record over and over and over and over and over again?
What was his name? Did he not give his name, the coward?
He didn't give his name, but I have his address.
But it's okay. But he obviously hasn't listened to the records, because if he'd have listened to them, he would have noticed that I wasn't making them over and over again. In fact, to answer his question, in 1979, I went into the studio to do the record to follow up Bat Out of Hell. And I quit the business because I said right then and there I was not going to duplicate Bat Out of Hell, because there was a song called Bad for Good that was a duplication of Bat Out of Hell. There was a song called Dance in My Pants, which was trying to be Paradise. And the answer to his question is he should listen to the records. No, I don't make the same record over and over again. But thanks for the question.
Now, some people actually, when Bat Out of Hell 2 came out, some people were actually saying that, you know, this was, you know, the comeback of the decade for Meat Loaf. Now, you look at it totally differently, don't you? You don't look at it as being...
Well, I don't look at what the world, in parentheses, calls commercial success as a comeback. Personal success is a comeback. When I, after 79, because I really, like, lost it from, you know, 79 pretty much to 84. And because of my wife, like I said, I came back in 85, not to what everybody considers as commercial success and selling millions and millions of records, but to personal success, because I came back and I started recording again and I started enjoying my work. And that's what really counts. And I was saying that up to 93, and everybody would sit around and look at me and go, yeah, that's just because he hadn't sold any records. They're called cynics. And And now then, after Bat 2 and it sold 12 million, I still have the same philosophy, that success is in your mind. It's not how much money you got in your pocket or how many records you sell.
All right, cool.
Now, also on this on the new album, on the previous albums, you actually worked with Jim Steinman, and he's got a little bit of a contribution on this record. We also worked with Ron Neverson on this. And you actually described this record as being the best vocal album that you've ever recorded. Why is
Not everything, because I hate most things anyway, but on a song called Martha, written by Tom Waits, which I've been singing for years and years and years. We sold at Carnegie Hall in 75, Steinman and myself, and we did it that night. And I said that Martha was the best vocal that I've ever done on a record, and that another song called Not a Dry Eye in the House was probably as good as any. And it's just, I felt real good about this record. I mean, if you'd asked me last May, what I was going to be doing now, I'd be telling you that I'd be in the studio with Jim Steinman finishing this record. But the record just sort of came together, and Jimmy, on June 12th, said, look, finish your record, let's do Bat 3 together. So that's what we're shooting for. Jimmy wants to call it Batter to Hell 3, the final at bat.
All right. You know, we're going to come back and...
That's a baseball thing, you know?
Finally, that baseball
you got
thing,
that. Yeah, you got that.
We're going to come back and we're going to have phones, more phone calls, more faxes with this intimate interactive with Meat Loaf. Plus, more performance. I'd Lie For You, the major hit. When we come back, right here at the INI. Hello. Checking me out through some dirty windows. I'll go right out there and clean them real soon. How you doing outside? You all right? Make some noise. Go and say hello. I know it's cold out there. They probably can't hear me. Yeah, hi, how are you? Poor people, sorry. Anyway, you know what? We have a question for Meat, and it's a live speaker's corner, so why don't we check that out?
Hi, Meat Loaf. My name's Jeff. I'm from Mississauga. I want to know, how did your rock and roll dream come true?
Oh, let me see him again. Don't take him away. Oh, there you are. How did my rock and roll dream come true? Just the fact that I'm able to do it. That's when you do something that you really have fun with and you really love, and you love your work. That's a dream, no matter what it is. That's a dream, and this is. Right here now, I mean, I know that's really cliche sounding, but right here now, and every time that we get to perform and I get to stand in front of this band, it's a dream.
All right. It's about that time.
Also, back in the late 70s when I was drinking all that beer, that was a dream too, man, let me tell you. Drinking all that champagne.
Okay, you know what? We're going to actually take a fax. Is that cool? Sure, well, let's just take a fax question. The question to Meat, what is the girl's name in your video, I'd Lie For You, and that's the...
Truth.
Truth. Yes, no, I know that, but it's actually spelled T-R-Y-T-H, but hey.
Oh, he's from England. So,
this is from Nikki.
Her name is Dana Patrick. She is a... she's a model, and she was also in the video Anything For Love. She didn't sing either one of them. Patty sang I'd Lie For You, and that's the truth. And a young lady who lives in Newcastle, England, named Lorraine Newman. Crosby. Lorraine Newman. She was on Saturday Night Live. I got confused with my Lorraines. She sang that, but Dana Patrick was in the video because I thought she could act. But obviously in the scene at the end with the money, I was wrong.
All right, it's about...
That was a joke. Thanks. Kick your ass if you don't laugh.
All right. It's about that time for another live performance here. And we're going to check out the latest hit, and it's called...
I'd Lie For You.
And that's the truth.
Do you know something? I just got to bring this up before we do this. That it's On all the singles and everything I've seen, it's in parentheses. It's not supposed to be in parentheses. I only figured that out 2 days ago. It's been out here around the world, and I look at it, and I go, who put that in parentheses? It's really just, I'd lie for you, and that's the truth. I don't know who did that. Anyway, here's the song. This is Patty Russo, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
rest of a while for you.
Do anything you ask me to.
Thank you, Patty. Thank you. That was beautiful. Thank you. Thanks, Meat. Yeah. Woo! Give me a quick second here. Would you like tissue? Right?
Oh, excuse me. I was just giving a note to my piano player.
Okay. You know, I want to ask you, and I think that song is a perfect example, the passion. Where does that, I mean, as a performer, like, I mean, some performers have it. I mean, some people can just get up there and just sing a song, but you have passion.
Okay, I can explain this to you.
Thanks, I'll sit over here.
Okay. It comes from this, and it's built in to what I do. And what I do is I take a lyric. You don't, it's like it kind of goes back to that question that guy asked me. If he listened to the records, if these guys, we were cutting a track, and I hear anything that I heard before on anything, I always go, no, don't do that. I've heard that before. Play something different. And what I do lyrically is that I will take the lyrics to a song, and Chasm is a true testament to this, because he kept writing a song for this record that I just kept sending back to him. Because I send them back and send them back. I do it to Jim Steinman, and I keep going, the lyrics aren't right. Because the lyrics have to do this. The lyrics have to not only be from my point of view as the singer, they must be about your point of view if I'm singing to you, and they must also be from the point of view of these people out here. So I circle the lyric and draw every bit out of it that you can get out of it. And the passion just but the passion to it is inherent in it. You don't have to work for it. The minute the song starts, it comes because it's built. It's just like the stuff that I do is about the stuff in your life where you go, this can't be happening. I mean, this isn't real. This isn't real. It is real. Take the song on life for you, and that's the truth. These two people are completely out of their minds. They're talking about, listen, honey, I'd walk across the fire for you. Oh, darling. I mean, they're gone. If you see them out on the street, these two people, everybody goes, hey, check those two out over there, man. They're hysterical. But if you're living their life, it's not funny. The passion is there. The fire's burning. So, right. There you go.
Thank you.
That was a long answer to your question.
But, yeah. That's who you are. All right. We have Paul from North York on the line. Paul, you have a question?
I do. I'd like to just say to Meat, thanks very much for doing this, I, and thanks for entertaining so many of us for so long. A lot of people, I believe, have fallen in love to your music, me being one of them. I'd like to know, are you aware of that? And if so, did this have any influence on the writing of this album? And will this album carry on that tradition?
I didn't hear that. I heard the end, but I didn't hear his middle part. Something about something.
Paul from North York, just give us the middle again.
Okay. Are you aware of the fact that a lot of people have fallen in love to your music? And if you are, does that have any influence in your writing? And do you think this album will carry on that tradition?
Nothing really influences it. It's just I get something stuck in my head, and that's what it is. But do I know that people have fallen in love? Listen, I can't tell you how many people have come up to me and told me, hey, man, I got laid in the back seat to Paradise by the Dashboard Light. My favorite is that the women who come up to me and go, I gave birth and Paradise by the Dashboard Light was playing. And the reason they can do that is because the damn thing is so long, you know? And what are you doing? Don't rap, don't stay, don't be doing this with me here now. So anyway, he got a little guy down here, he's going like this, wrap it up, come on, we gotta go quick. So anyway, and the answer to his question is, I really care about what I do, bottom line, I really care. So, and I'm happy that people, you know, got laid and had babies and fell in love, and I mean, that's what life's about, those are those moments.
And judging from this album, there's more babies on the way. All right, we'll be back with more Meat Loaf right here at the Intimate and Interactive Questions, Faxes, everything Meat Loaf's in the house. Well, it's about that time for another live performance from Meat Loaf from the Bat Outta Hell 2 album, Life is a Lemon.
It's not a game, it's just a mess. There's desperation.
defective. And so is making any hay.
What about sex?
It's defective. It's never built to really last.
What about your family?
It's defective. All the batteries are shot.
What about your friends?
They're defective. All the parts are out of stock.
What about home?
It's defective. It goes loaded and decayed.
What about faith?
It's defective. It's tattered and it's frayed.
What about your gods?
They're defective. They've a god no warranty.
What about your town?
It's defective. It's a dead end straight to me.
What about your school?
It's defective. It's a bad game of useless lay.
What about your work?
It's defective. It's a crock and in your day.
What about your childhood?
It's defective. It's in a very
Life is a level.
The party definitely continues. You gotta come on back, because we get to hear the classic song, Bat Out of Hell, I and I with Meat Loaf. Interactive with Meat Loaf, and on my left hand side, who are you?
Lena.
And you on my right hand side?
Marie.
Are you having a good time?
Yes.
You having a good time?
Great time.
It's wonderful, isn't it? Great. All right, here's the deal. We have a speaker's corner from Montreal. So, Meat, listen up. There's a question for you.
Listen carefully.
I'm Z from Montreal, and we're all just wondering here if your legendary role in the Rocky Horror Picture Show is still haunting you to this day, because it's such a cult classic.
Okay, I'm going to answer that question really quickly here. Anything that brings that much enjoyment to that many people couldn't possibly haunt you at all. Everything that I've ever done, I don't have a weight around my neck. There is no albatross around my neck. I love the Rocky Horror Picture Show. I love Richard O'Brien. I've learned a lot from Tim Curry. And it was a wonderful experience for me.
All right, we got a question in the house. What's your name?
My name is Corrado.
All right, and what's your question, Corrado?
My question is just very basic. When you came up with Bat Out of Hell, the album had a very, very distinct sound to it. I guess what people would call rock opera. During that time, there was a lot of I guess you would call it rock funk and hard rock and that disco era. Why did you choose that way, to go the rock opera way instead of blending in with everybody, I guess?
We didn't choose that. I mean, that wasn't something, we didn't sit out and go, okay, we're gonna do this. This is just what evolved. I mean, I never fit in, okay? I'm on an island all by myself, babe. I am true alternative, okay? Thanks.
All right, we have Bob from St. John's. Hi, Bob, how you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Got a question, baby?
Yeah, Meat Loaf, welcome back to Canada, first of all.
Thank you very much.
And a couple of years ago, you were in Newfoundland. You may remember that account.
Oh, I wanted to know if you which St. John's you were in. You're in St. John's, Newfoundland, right?
Right.
I was an honorary. Remember, I did the thing with the fish and the thing and the rubber boot and the hat and all that stuff. I kissed the fish's ass or something, right? Whatever I was supposed to do.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I wanted to.
I don't know. Ate guts from a squid or something.
I remember you mentioning that on stage. One thing I wanted to ask you, kind of different from everybody else's questions, voice preparation for when you're going into a concert or anything like that, and how do you stay away from things like diseases that you might pick up in your mouth and your throat and that kind of thing?
You don't. You have to try to stay in shape all the time, which, like I said before we came back on the air, I said, we're not touring, I'm out of shape. And so you just do, but you can't. Listen, see these guys back here? This is like being in second grade. You know, remember when you were in second grade, you caught every disease that everybody else had? Same thing. Well, not every disease, okay?
All right, here's the deal. We're wrapping up. Meat, thank you. The band, thank you. Thank you, make some noise. You, everyone out there, thank you. Are you gonna take us home, baby?
Oh, let's go, man of the hell.
Kick it, man, let's go, come on.
killer in the sky, killers on the bloodshot street. Down in the tunnel with the deadly horizon, oh, I swear I saw a young boy down in the gutter. He was starting to foam in the heat. A sinner before the gates of heaven open. A sinner before the gates of heaven now come crawling back.
Thank you.
Keep it going. Thank you all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot, man. Thank you in the back. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. This has been a Muchmusic production. Thank you.
Yeah. Keep rocking.
You got it.
Never, ever stop rocking.